the Passion Translation, go back to that other scripture. In the Passion Translation in Psalm 81:10, listen to this. I love the way it's written. It says here, I am your only God, the living God. Wasn't I the one who broke the strongholds over you and raised you up out of bondage? Open your mouth with a mighty decree, and I will fulfill it now, and you'll see. The words that you speak, so shall it be. See, we have to really be careful and understand, and one of the next slides that's going to come up is life and death are in the power of our tongue, one of the slides somewhere. And in the Passion Translation, I know you're working with me, Adriel. Don't worry about this. It's hard for me to follow an outline. Proverbs 18:21 says, the Passion Translation, your words are so powerful that they will kill or give life. And a talkative person will reap the consequences. I mean, listen to that. What are you saying over yourself? What are you saying over your family? What are you saying over your job? What are you saying over, you know, your health? Our words are so powerful, they will kill. They will kill or give life. Speak life. Life and death, the Bible says, are in the power of our tongue. And so I want to speak life. I want to believe the words, and I want to harmonize. I want to be aligned with the word of God. I want to be in sync. What's the word say? The word says you're more than a conqueror. It doesn't say you're a failure. The word says that he is powerful. I have his DNA in me. That means I'm powerful. The word says that I have the mind of Christ. You can't be stupid. Because the Bible says you have the mind of Christ. You see? So that's, again, where we have to shift what we're thinking. And, you know, when I got saved, I wanted to see results. Because everything was miserable in my life. And I thought, well, if I'm going to do it, I'm going for it. And you know what? I saw the miracle working power of God. I experienced it. And it wasn't because I knew someone. It wasn't because I had a prophetic word. I got hold of the word. And I meditated on the word, and I saw major breakthrough. It wasn't without a fight. I'm going to tell you. It wasn't without a fight. And we'll talk about that. I was reading an article, and I wrote it somewhere. I have a lot of papers here. And anyway, oh, here it is. No, I got it.
I just want to say something. I didn't mention it, but this week on Tuesday night in our Possessing Your Vessel class, we're going to be talking about inner vows. And that's just another one of those voices inside that you're not always aware of, but you might have made this vow as a child. I'm never going to amount to anything. I'll always be a failure. All these things is another form of lying that the enemy does against us. So as Trisha's talking about this, just do a little self-examination and say, where could I have gotten, you know, tainted? Where am I running on bad fuel that could actually be stopping me? And come out on Tuesday night. You know, you don't have to have been going to all the other classes to still benefit from what we're doing on Tuesdays. Thanks.
So I was reading this article about all these scientists, and there was one of the articles that was Russian scientist that says that they can prove their DNA can be reprogrammed by just our words. Think about that. Then there was another article where it had scientists from Holland, from Finland, from all over Europe, and where they were focusing on when we are speaking positive, and we're speaking words of life, what it does. And so at the conclusion of one of the articles that I read, it said, this is scientists, this was not Christian. It says, when a great number of people get together and they pray or meditate, all focusing on the same outcome, their prayers can change the world. It says, this concept is a known fact. This was secular. So the Lord is telling us to upgrade. See, the enemy knows how powerful our words are. He knows how powerful the word of God is. So if he can get us to back off, or to just respond to what's happening and get depressed and say, forget God, doesn't work. That's what he wants. Because life and death are in the power of our tongue. Our words are powerful. They kill or they give life. What are you speaking? So, Lord, what's in our soul? Lord, is there fear in our soul? Do you think less of yourself? You know, it could be trauma from your past because it does affect us. The Bible says, and I'll quote it sometime later, Adriel. Out of the abundance of our heart, our mouth speaks. So whatever's in us is going to come out in that during that trial. But you know what's so awesome about God? He's not looking to hit you over the head with a hammer. He's saying, just check out your heart. This is what could be hindering you. And that it's like, okay, I have to course correct here, Lord. You know, yeah, I'm having a little problem in this area believing you. That happens. You don't just believe, well, at least I didn't. Just maybe some do, just believe right away. But it took me, a while getting the word in me. But it's so worth it. So in this 2020 season of spiritual vision, of decreeing the word of the Lord, what scriptures are you standing on? What's the word of God that's in your heart? Because remember, Jesus framed the world. God framed the world with his words. Read through Genesis 1, read through Hebrews. You know, he says, I frame the world with my words. We are framing our world with our words. Remember, we are our own prophets over our own lives. What are you prophesying over yourself? What are you decreeing over yourself? So we have to believe that we have a dunamis power within us. Jane Hammond spoke a really good word on this year, and she spoke it at Glory of Zion, so you can probably get it online, but it's really a good word. And she was talking about the Lord woke her up and said that we are dynamos. And in when he says that in Acts chapter 1:8, that he shall give you power, in Jerusalem, Judea, and the uttermost parts of the world, that word is dunamis. And it's throughout the Bible. It's throughout the New Testament. One of the words is dunamis. The other one's exousia. But it means dynamite, explosive power. See, we have to believe when we're reading it, and you need to speak of yourself and say, I am a dynamite, powerful man or woman of God. I have the Spirit of God in me. And the more you say it, your faith is developed, the more you start seeing yourself that way. Remember, when you're in agreement and in alignment with what the Spirit of the Lord is saying, that's when you have breakthrough. Another thing about 2020, when you look up the word 20, it means expectancy and waiting. So they that wait upon the Lord, their strength shall be renewed like the eagles. You're waiting and you're declaring and you're praying. And it doesn't mean you have to wait 25 years. It's just that God, the fragrance of heaven is faith. And so God wants us to shut our mouths when we need to shut our mouths and speak the word of the Lord when we need to speak the word of the Lord, sing the songs of the Lord. You know, worship is very powerful. And one of the things that they said in the article was the difference in what happens in our brain and our DNA when we're worshiping, when we're singing. So for those of you who don't like to worship, I'm just saying, you know, if you come in a little earlier, it might help you out. So put the worship on, practice at home. We have to decree and declare the impossible as possible. We have to decree that we're breaking out of all the limitations. But here's the thing. It's not just decreeing. It's being a person of action. It's also being obedient to the word of God. It's also listening and asking the Lord, hey, am I stubborn in any area where I'm not even listening to counsel? See, you can get off kilter here again. So in a multitude of counsel, there's safety. But where am I not experiencing breakthrough? Well, then if you haven't, then there's the problem with you. And that's what you have to ask the Lord. What am I doing that I'm causing myself to go around that mountain over and over and over and over again? We all have to do it. See, because God's saying to us, I'm inviting you to go beyond. I don't want you to be status quo. I don't want you to be limited. I'm asking you to go beyond. But see, how many of you, if I say that, or you want to break out the limitations, you have 14 excuses as to why it won't work. Wow. You know, what's the deal there? What are you saying? What's your self-talk? Because we need to speak life over ourselves. Our self-talk, if it's not aligning with the word of God, then it's a soulish issue. And again, it's like, all right, Lord, I repent because, you know, or it could be habit from your family. Oh, you know, they never thought you'd make it. You never get ahead. You'll never do any better. Do you agree with that? Now, you could in your mind, but you may be saying something else, but that's where everything has to come into alignment. What words are you speaking? Lord, I know it's been a difficult time, and I know I haven't seen breakthrough. How many times have we heard, I have not had a father, and I don't know how to be a good father? Well, he's the good father. And the word of God teaches us how to be good parents, right? But that doesn't mean that you're going to be stuck But it starts with decreeing that thing, because he says, my words are above your words, my thoughts are above your thoughts. He knows what he's doing well. We can't limit God.